Hey, what's up, guys? And welcome back to some more Northgard gameplay. Another Northgard guide for this time the Stag clan. So I've been reading your comments, and one of you guys wanted to said that the powerful one, most powerful one for them, was the Stag clan. So I might as well, since the Snake clan is quite overpowered, I'm gonna do another normal clan that you just get for free. And that will be the Stag clan, and in this case, alright, let's get started. And I just want to say that if you guys ever do a Northgard game in general, just spam warriors. Never do axe throwers. Never do like axe throwers or skirmishers. Warriors that are really fragile, because when the enemy's defending with a defense tower, the axe throwers are just gonna die pretty quick. I've just been always noticing that in general. So yeah, guys, as usual, just start off with the house and scout camp. That's really for any clan. Start scouting out before you actually colonize and see which land you want. For example, I'll be taking this forest over here, because that will be the wood resource I will be using for the rest of the game here. Alright guys, let us do this. Excuse me. Yeah, guys, I want you to make sure whenever you play this game, military-wise, always go warriors. They're just obviously by far the best to go, easiest to use. If you're not that good at kiting, the kiting skill, axe throwers are definitely not the thing for you, because they die quite fast if you don't kite. And just in general, they're just gonna get killed pretty easily, even if you do know how to kite. I actually tried recording this video before using the Stag clan, but using axe throwers, and it didn't go that well. So this time, for myself, I'm just gonna be going with the good old, warriors, because that's always worked best for me. New friendly, you know? That's my style. So what you want to go here is a silo build. So, at least have two fully upgraded silos. We want to get advanced silos, because you get +4 food no matter what if upgraded. So if you really go insane in military, you will be supported on that end, because you'll, no matter what, just if the silos are there, you get +4 food, even if they're, whether you have people there or not. Just having silos there gives you +8 if you have two upgraded silos, so it's pretty good. Thank you. comfortable. Start to breathe a bit. Since I'm trying to not breathe into my mouth. There we go. When I talk, though, I'll bring the mic back close to my face so you guys can hear me.
Thank you.
just like being aggressive. All adventure and fire is pretty good. Oh yeah, let me just bring up the mic closer to my face so you guys can hear me. There we go. Trolling, I have to say. They're not ranged drug or perfect way to farm some military points. When you know I'm facing against the snake clan, that's just great. Get up to 99%, and then when we're ready, we have a full army. We can use spectral orders too to help our cause, so that'll be pretty good.
Thank you.
Get increased cap. Oh, I'm only getting skulls right now. So once when you're unhappy, you get reduced production. So that's why that's now that issue's now fixed. Thank you. these bastards, these skirmishers. There you go. Look at that, guys. Look at that. That's a beauty right there, plus a 19. Because of the advanced CLOs I have. Yeah. For you, basic representation. Just put your food tiles here, you'll be good for food for the rest of the game, unless you need to convert, of course, to soldiers, and then be a bit low on food at that point, because yeah, you gotta do what you need to do to defeat your opponent. Even though violence is not always the answer, in this game it is. Definitely is. Plus 10. Thank you. you. I see you. I see you. Chiefs are experienced units that bring their strength and leadership to bear in combat. Hopefully this person is actually good. They're pretty crap compared to Sydney, because Sydney bloody has freaking spear attack. disadvantage with this stupid melee weapon building, weren't you? That is okay. We can still make it work, I think. Hopefully. It's almost been an hour. Oh, thanks for the food, I appreciate it. Oh no, he stopped. Wow. How rude. And I can improve the tools, so should be getting a lot of coins out of this.
Mic off. Mic on.
Sorry guys, just had to get it off for a sec. Alright. that's where Max will do it again. I don't want to just have skirmishers there, bro. Oh, the under pressure. For extra happiness. Yeah, that's smart. I never would think of doing it like that. So it just automatically repairs if it's on fire. Guys are gonna get destroyed. I didn't even use that many crowns, so we'll look at that. Micromanage, guys, if you can. Take as little casualties as possible. And cry chop that guy. There we go. Dead. Literally just annihilated the whole entire force there, guys. It's pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. It felt pretty good. Oh. Just keep that there. Cut through them like butter. That's literally what we're gonna do. Thank you. I don't know why these losers are even trying still, but, you know. Let's let them try, shall we? I hate that. Seemingly despise it. Towers here, so I'm just gonna push through this way. Yeah. Stop raid. Stop raid. Need to convert everyone to a soldier. I need like 20 of them. Victory here. We're just gonna convert everyone here. So we'll keep going. If he's going. Just gonna be really bad for them. I'm not gonna lie, it's gonna hurt. They don't have any towers. Literally, we're just gonna push through all their defenses with like 20 soldiers. It's like gonna be the strongest army I've ever had. Guys, they don't stand a chance. Guys, this is the strongest army I ever had. I hope you guys are proud of me.
Mic off.
I could have had like even 20 if I wanted to, but I'm just gonna end it with like this. to pay for this person any longer. Still, plus 8 food. Got 19 warriors. It's pretty good. I could have won from the warriors, but this is more than enough. Some people have like more than 20, and it's just crazy. And they do it even faster than me, so honestly, I get. Here. Whatever we want. Or I guys, that was some more Northgard gameplay. Please leave any comments on what you want me to do for future, like guides or tutorials. If you want me to keep playing Northgard, or if you want some multiplayer content in Northgard or a new game, just put down in the comments. And as always, guys, oh yeah, and leave a like if you enjoyed and subscribe for more videos and content from this channel. And as always, guys, I'll see you in the next one.